Here we have abracadabra. As it starts to open, I have to film it at night because I won't be here. You can see already how dark some places of the red are and also the yellow part. So with abracadabra, there is always the risk that the flower will not have the variegation. However, this one appears to have a very wonderful upcoming flower with many petals and a lot of variegation. And here it is, abracadabra as it bloomed. So this is how it is 5 days later. You can see that here the bud next to it has powdery mildew. So actually this one is one of the roses prone to powdery mildew. And I want to say that actually it was not raining throughout these 5 days. It was rather warm. And because people say that the powdery mildew comes when the rains are there. But yes, what a truly beautiful flower. It gave us and so thick, full with petals. Actually, the color is more dark. Here, I try to change the white balance to try to show you how dark red this is and yellow. And it's nice that it has not only one flower. However, the powdery mildew is one of the problems. And it's really nice that it's so full, and they did not receive water for probably 6 days, and some of the roses are in really bad condition. However, this one is not, so I'm really thankful that it is somewhat resistant to drought. But yeah, even here, powdery mildew on the neck of the rose. Here it is, abracadabra, as it opened even more, and it becomes even darker, so it's close to black red. It's hard to showcase the color because, like I said many times, the phones are changing and trying to make everything brighter. But yes, it's very stunning. And you can see here at the center these twirls. And it has this type of leaves. It does not have thorns, not even on the back side of the leaves. This is Hocus Pocus. Then we have Belle de Espinos, abracadabra, Scented Jewel,